Hi, this is Gary with MacMost.com. On this episode, let me show you some useful calculator tricks for your Mac. So the calculator app is a really cool, powerful app that comes with your Mac. I'm not even going to look at some of the really advanced stuff that's in here. Like for instance, you can go to scientific calculator or programmer calculator. I'm going to stick with the basic one. And I'm not even going to look at all the different ways you can convert numbers using the calculator. Just using the basic calculator here, there's some really cool things. It looks like a regular calculator, so you may want to use it just like that. But there's some functions that you can't do. For instance, say you're typing a number and you realize you've just typed a wrong digit. On a regular calculator, of course, there's no delete key. And there's no delete button on this one, but you can use the delete key on your keyboard to delete the ones you've just typed in. So if you're typing in a really long number and you make a mistake, you can use the delete key and correct it. That's just one of the many things that you can do that you can't do with a regular calculator. One of the things you can do here is you can set the number of decimal places. So for instance, say you want to calculate sales tax on something. So something is going to cost $399 and the local sales tax is 7.3%. So you're going to add 7.3%. Now that gives you the $29 extra there. And that's something a regular calculator does, and if you hit equals now, it will perform that addition there, and you get your total of $428.12, but you have that extra decimal place. You don't really want that there because you're doing calculations based on money. So instead, you can go and go to View, Decimal Places, and set the number of decimal places to 2. So it always now round. So whatever calculation you do, you can always count on it just giving you 2 decimal places. There you go. So I get 2 decimal places even though there are more mathematically behind it. This is all I'm going to actually have to pay when I buy the item. Now if you've ever had to do a lot of calculations with a calculator, you know that one way to speed it up is use 2 people. One person's actually reading out the numbers, the other person does the calculation and then reads the number back, and you can kind of fill in long lists of numbers that way. And you can do something similar here with calculator because you can turn on speech. So you can turn on speak results.
Speech enabled.
And now I can type something like 8 plus 9, and when I hit equals
17,
it automatically reads it out. Now in a simple example like this, it doesn't make much sense, but when you have something that's a little bit more complex, like what we were looking at before,
29.13, 428.13.
So it makes a lot more sense now. Now even a cheap calculator that you get at a drugstore or a supermarket will have a memory button here. And there's none here on this simple calculator. But you don't really need it because you're on a computer and you've got things like copy and paste. And you can use that here. So I can basically say, say 7 plus 8 equals, and anytime I want to copy what's in that window there, I can do Edit, Copy, or Command C. And I can clear this out and be performing another calculation, 2 plus 3 plus 9 plus, and at this point, instead of typing a number, I can actually paste, and we'll paste in what I had copied, and we'll treat it just as if I typed it in. So you can use copy and paste to actually substitute for memory functions. Now I want to show you my very favorite trick in calculator. If you go to Window, Show Paper Tape, you get this little window here that will show you all the calculations you've recently performed, and it will continue to record them. So if you do a new calculation, it'll put it right there and it'll just continue to accumulate these even to the point where it's going to scroll. And you can go into this window and scroll up and down and see your calculations. And if you're doing a calculation like you see this a lot in calculators where you say you do 9 times 2 equals, and then the last operation I did was times 2. So if I hit equals again, it will re-perform that calculation. So it'll do times 2 again. It'll show you the full calculation here, 9 times 2 times 2, and you can continue to do that. And you could see not just you know, what you think is 144 times 2, but it actually will show you, no, what it actually did was 9 times 2 times 2 times 2 times 2 times 2, and there's the result. So you get this great paper tape here that includes everything that you're doing, and it will allow you to go back basically and see results. So you can see here I did that sales tax calculation here. Now you can use this also for memory because you can copy out of it. So I can go back to something I was doing earlier, say, ah, oh, that's that calculation here. I'm going to select it, Command C to copy, and then I'll do 9 plus, and then I'll do Command V to paste. And I can perform a new calculation using that number. So it's very easy to go back here and grab something and use this as an extended memory of everything you've done and all the results. And as you can expect, not only can you copy large sections and paste them, say, into a document, but you could also save the tape, and it will save it out. So we'll just save it here to the desktop. It will open up in text edit. And in addition to that, you can even print the tape as well. So the tape itself is just such a really cool function that takes this very simple calculator and goes well beyond it, and just makes it very useful.